Welcome to my channel. I'm here to make you think. I'm here to enlighten you and show you things that I peek. But before I do that, can you please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel? And be sure to ring that post notification bell so that you can receive a notification the moment I drop a video. And I thank you in advance. Welcome back. I grew up in a church that was called a Baptist church, but I grew up as Christian. And you know, when you go to church as a child, you know, you see a lot of strange things, but you accept them because, you know, you're programmed to think that this is normal, you know? So when I used to go to church when I was little, even as an adult, I would see people, you know, hooping and hollering, dancing all around the church, you know, claiming to have caught the Holy Ghost, right? So you might see people fainting, you know, people passing out, dancing uncontrollably, you know, sweating, needing water. You know, you used to have the nurses that work at the church, they'll take people out, fan them down, give them water and stuff, because, you know, you see them because they quote-unquote having the Holy Ghost, right? But I would see that when, you know, it comes from a preacher speaking, or a preacher might be talking and the person may get excited, but I know it's really just energy in the room that causes people to do that. It's not no Holy Ghost being caught, because you already know I don't believe in that shit about the Holy Ghost and all of that. So anyway, I'm just going to talk about, you know, there is a pastor, you know, a South African pastor who claims that he can heal people, okay? But he has his own way of healing. A lot of churches have given, you know, they claim to have healing powers. They'll place their hand on top of the forehead, which is really replacing covering up your chakra, but that's another video. They place a hand on your forehead and, you know, try to force you to fall down and stuff like that because they claim that they have these powers, right? But whoa, 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 wait till you hear what this pastor does. He has his own way of doing a healing. Now, this is going to sound strange, and this might make you want to pass out, because I almost fainted when I heard of it. Because it was so weird and strange. It's like, who comes up with this stuff? Like, I don't even understand how the congregation even deals with this. Like, how would they even still go to a church like this where a man is doing this? But like I said, when you go to church, you know, I'm not judging nobody, but I feel like people who go to church are people who probably have, like, mental problems. They can't see things for what they are, so they feel like they need something to continue to go on or live, whatever. Rules to abide by, whatever. I'm going to talk to you about, here he is. His name is Pastor Christ Penelope. He has been accused of farting on his church members, okay? Farting, passing gas, carbon monoxide from his rear end on top of their head and their nostrils and all this stuff. He comes from the Sevenfold Holy Spirit Ministries, okay? He's a South African pastor, okay? He claims that he's healing them by farting on their faces and nostrils. I mean, he thinks that this is healing them, and I guess this, according to them, it does, which is the most weirdest thing I've ever heard. He claims that his farts anoint and they perform miracles instantly, okay? Not, you know what I'm saying, not down the line. But he say instantly, you know what I'm saying? He say his farts work immediately, okay? Instantly. Instant farts work for instant prayers. Whatever. Earlier last year, it was reported that, you know what I'm saying, dozens and dozens of people were waiting in the church for him, you know, waiting on the so-called holy fart. Now, I'm looking at these are two different pictures, and I see he got the same pants on. Maybe those are his fart pants. I'm not sure. Maybe that's what it is. I don't know. But, you know what I'm saying? This is what he has been doing. This is some nasty shit. They call it the holy fart. Okay? Some people even wait 2 months to receive a fart on their forehead. Okay? These people also, you're not going to believe this. People also, okay, pay a lot of money to collect that aroma in a jar so they can always be able to smell it during like a business meeting or when they're trying to receive a deal. So they're using it as like a manifestation type. They're using the farts, the Holy Smart, as a way to win things and get things and receive things. He has them thinking that his smart, his farts from his butthole is actually doing something for them. And now they actually believe it too, because the programming is real. The programming is real. Now, I know all churches are not like this, but I wonder how many more churches are like this. Like, I can't even believe this is going on. Like, this cannot be true. You know what I'm saying? But if you put it in your mind and make it true, I mean, I guess it's true to them. But that's some of the nastiest shit I ever heard. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about nasty. Can you picture going into a church, you know, maybe it's your first time visiting, and you have no idea what this church is about, okay? And you walk in, you know, you sit down, you know, you go do the service, and all of a sudden you hear this pastor talking about, you know, if you need to be healed today, come down here and let me sit my ass on your face, and then we'll see if we can heal you. Can you imagine that? I mean, it sounds crazy, but can you imagine that? Because obviously, you know what I'm saying, people enjoy this, and he must be nasty. I mean, he got there, ain't no must to it. He is nasty as hell. Why is you putting your funky ass on somebody's face to fart on? Whatever. Anyway, that's what some of the churches have come to. I advise y'all to keep your third eyes open and just, you know what I'm saying, keep on waking up to the, you know, whatever you have questions on, keep on waking up. If you feel like, you know, you're going to be embarrassed about it, don't be. Nobody's here to judge you, you know what I'm saying? I'm only here to encourage and enlighten you to think and use that brain because you got it, you know what I'm saying? To all my subscribers, I'm going to call y'all my coffee drinkers. Thank you for coming and sipping coffee with me. Peace.